just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Boston College is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. The Tar Heels offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I've really recognized is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
Incomplete, wanted his receiver.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
Second and 10. Ball on the 37. Here we go. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. Catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
It's a smart job here by the coaches, making a play call here that really played to their offensive strengths. That's knowing your personnel.
Gets it. He's in space. And he's taken down right around the 28-yard line. The 25-yard line.
Now that's some pretty timid play calling right there. Let's see if they decide to open it up a bit more.
Tackle at the 17.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Some movement on the line.
Ball start. Offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
First and 15 now. Ball on the 22. Short over the middle. And down he goes at the 9. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
He's taken down at the 9-yard line. Around the 10-yard line.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
This isn't much more than an extra point. North Carolina is looking to go up by 3. The kick is up, and the field goal is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Quick throw out to the receiver. He's to the 40. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 46-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. And they hit him in the backfield.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
Take him down immediately. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. The Tar Heels lose one of their key players with that injury earlier. Still in the locker room. We don't know the severity, but unlikely that he'll play any more football this afternoon. And he's going to be sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Certainly, they don't have the return on here. He really got a hold of that one. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. North Carolina is up by three. Makes the catch, and look out. He gets hit out of bounds, right around the 36-yard line. He's got it with room to run. They'll bring him down around the 48-yard line.
I think play action is a big part of this offense and what they're trying to do today. It's, you know, they're running the football and they're mixing in some play action. And what that does is it freezes the linebackers and the safeties. It puts a lot of pressure on them to have to be able to defend both the run and the play action. And as a play caller, when I know I can go to play action pass, boy, I feel really good about it. It's getting my quarterback in rhythm, slowing down the defense, and giving us a chance to make big plays.
That makes it second and two.
Gets rid of it. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Here we go.
He's tackled at about the 33-yard line. He's out of bounds, right around the 32-yard line. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle made right around the 16-yard line. North Carolina has a three-point lead. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still first down.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They make the stop at the five. He gains a couple of yards on the carry. Touchdown, UNC. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A 10-play, 84-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. The score now, 10-0, and it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He's got the corner. Tackle at the 34-yard line. We're through one quarter. North Carolina's got a 10-point lead. For more action here in quarter number two. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Brought down right around the 48-yard line. That makes it first and 10. From their own 48-yard line. First down. He is drilled at the 50-yard line. That's a gain of 2 yards. That makes it 7 and 8.
Ready?
Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
Short yardage situation, and the offense is in the jumbo package. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35. This one's going deep to the end zone.
Number 10 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. He steps out at the 29.
Gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on 3rd down. Sets them up with a 1st and goal.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
This is the 9th play of this drive. He's taken down at the 2-yard line.
Gain of 8 on the play. That brings up 2nd and goal.
That brings up a 2nd and goal. Ball on the 2-yard line. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. Tackle around the 1-yard line. And this is the 11th play of the current drive.
Watch.
see. The draw within a field goal. And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Taken from the 3-yard line. He's tackled at the 23. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. North Carolina holds a field goal lead. They go to the left for a nice gain.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
From their own 27-yard line, third down. Sends it out quick, intercepted. And down he goes at the 34.
This safety always seems to be in the right place at the right time. It's no surprise that he comes up with the interception here.
They're not ready for this, man. They're not ready for this. That's gonna pass.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. He goes out of bounds at the 28-yard line. Second down, and they're gonna need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's taken down at the 11-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Got a man in and out of his hands. From the 11-yard line, it's second down. He makes it out to about the 8-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it 37.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. Moves up in the pocket. He's hit and taken down. This one should be makeable. Boston College is down 3 and looking to tie it up. Might have been some early movement up front.
False start, offense.
Sometimes what happens on a false start as a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
This should be an easy field goal. It's up, and it's through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the 2. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. Both defenses really played well so far.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Nearly picked off, but he couldn't hold it.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's to the 40. He's pushed out of bounds at the 44. From their own 44-yard line, first down. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. From the 38-yard line, it's first down. He can't get away from the pressure.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
In and out of his hands. Third down, and they need to get it to the 28. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
There's one the quarterback would like to rewind because he has a wide-open receiver, and he just misfires.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That'll make it second and four.
We've played a half of football and a 10-10 tie in this game.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw, both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickeration?
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run some reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
Heading into the third quarter now. Tie ball game. We're set to resume play. Taken at the five. gets to about the 27-yard line. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Just throws this one away. Second and 10. Ball on their own 27. He's to the 40, and he's tackled at the 43. Give to the tailback. They'll bring him down right around the 46-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Second and seven. Ball on the 46-yard line. Fires out to his wideout. He's tackled at about the 49. He zips it, and this one falls incomplete. He really got a hold of that one. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Fires right side, got his tailback. Tackle made at about the 21. Looking for the corner. Makes it out to about the 30. Nice run there as they work the outside. The stop at the 46. Flags are all over the place and they'll blow it dead.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still first down.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
And he just gets rid of it. That was incomplete, and it looked exactly like their last pass.
It was exact same play, and I think the offensive coordinator just tried to pull a fast one.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back, and he's shoved out of bounds around the 48-yard line. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. He fields the punt at the 13.
And he's tackled at the 23-yard line.
Nice yardage on the run back. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping.
Throws it out, and it falls incomplete. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Tries to thread the needle, and it's not going to work. Brought down at the 30-yard line.
The linebacker here does a good job with his instincts and getting in the path of the receiver. Boy, what a great play.
To the back and hit hard for a loss. And that one's incomplete.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. Fights forward to about the 30. North Carolina could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he nails the long field goal. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line.
North Carolina is the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence. It's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Gains his way to the 40-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 40. Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks.
That makes it second and 6.
Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds at the 46-yard line. They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. It's away, and it's a booming punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. The Eagles have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
We're set to get restarted as the offense looks to build on the success of their field goal on the last drive. Complete. He's got room. Out of bounds at the 28.
That makes it second and 2.
North Carolina is up a field goal.
Let's go.
Check three.
On
the catch, and he steps out. So they'll pick up a first down there on a 4-yard completion.
Nothing special here. Quick pass and a good catch, but it keeps the chains moving.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap, and he threw it right out there. Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he's taken down around the 33-yard line. Down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
So the penalty makes it first and 15. Quick throw. He goes out of bounds. Right around the 50. Through three quarters now. And still, the defenses are shining. 13-10, Tar Heel. Great three quarters of action. Tight ball game. And now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it. North Carolina holds a field goal lead. Here's a receiver screen, falls incomplete.
Number 16 on the intended receiver on the play.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. He's taken down at about the 17-yard line.
Huge play for both the quarterback and receiver, but it all starts with the big fellas up front who provided the time to get the quarterback a chance to throw.
He's into the open field. The five. Touchdown, North Carolina. Tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Tar Heels have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. And down he goes at the 25. So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere. From their own 25-yard line. Second down. He wants it all going long. And it's caught to the 20, to the 10. Touchdown, Eagles. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
It makes for an easy completion when you've got a guy who's that wide open. Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. And he adds the extra point. A quick two-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
Boston College is ready to kick it away. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. A score here might effectively end this one. North Carolina is up by three. And he's tackled around the 31-yard line. Looks to the back and can't connect. From their own 31-yard line, it's third down. Slings it. That's a great tackle at the 35. Excellent punt. Tackle at the 30. And he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
Yeah, this offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receivers. Because, again, they put so much time in trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a playmaker.
We've got a second and 14. Ball on the 25-yard line. Slings it quickly to his halfback again. They'll bring him down around the 29-yard line. They pick up at the most 4 yards on the screen play. Just under three to go in regulation. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's tackled around the 46-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 46.
Mike nine. Here we go. Mike, check. 98 Weasel.
And he's level at the 41. Taken down behind the line. From the 42-yard line, second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. He's got it with room to run. Tackle made at the 20. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Quickly, he's got the tailback on another catch. And he tackles him hard at the 17.
Number four with the tackle at the 17-yard line.
This is the ninth play of this drive.
Second and 7.
Mike 56.
He
fights forward to about the 16. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Another run. Just a tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ball game. And now the offense has got a chance to win it. It's up, and it's through the uprights. Boston College lines up for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Broke away from one. Tackle made at the 25-yard line. Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership. He's on the run. And they make the stop at the 26. They come out on an empty backfield. With the pass, incomplete. Third down, 9 to go. Ball on the 26. Quick throw to the tight end. Brought down around the 36-yard line. The Tar Heels taking their first time out of the half. They come out in a 5-wide set. He's under pressure. They bring him down.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. He's knocked out of bounds at the 45-yard line. And I think they're going to take one last shot at the end zone here. He's got it. You got to think the way that offense dug deep to get the lead here this late in the fourth quarter, that might translate over and give enough emotion to their defense to win the football game. And he converts the extra point. North Carolina's staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.